Morning, everyone. Hope everybody's doing well. It is a beautiful Friday morning here in Ohio. Took the grandkids trick-or-treating last night. Got a little wet, but at least we got out. Doing a little bit something different today. I gotta go to the doctor or the hospital. I think I got a hand that's infected. I burned it in my forearm, and I think it's getting infected. So I'm gonna probably just go to the hospital today, get my hand looked at, or try to get into my physician. But other than that, I'm doing good. Maybe a little wind therapy would make me feel better. Maybe just riding a bike would be the medicine I need. It is beautiful here. Let's see what we got here. Let's turn this around. Boy, it is absolutely beautiful today. It's cold. It's cold. It's about 56 degrees, but you know what? It ain't raining, and it's the fall of the year, and we're still in peak color here in Ohio.
Morning, everyone. I'm over here in Indiana, headed toward Brookville.
Deer stand up in there somewhere.
This GoPro is acting up awful. I updated it and it just keeps shutting down. Gotta figure out what's going on with it. Well, I'm here at the Brookville Lake Reservoir. Let's go look at the overflow, or the overlook, so what it looks like this morning.
Man, this GoPro. Find another option. These GoPros have just got too many issues. I just cannot keep these things working. The software, I'm trying to update them, just ain't working. If anybody knows anything better, an alternative to a GoPro, let me know, because I sure would like to try it. Well, we're at Brookville Lake at the overlook at the dam. Let's go see what that looks like this morning.
Brookville Lake, United States Army Corps of Engineers, 1975. This is a big lake. I used to be into boating, but not no more.
Oh, it's a mystery to me. We have agreed. Which we have agreed, and you think you have to want more than you need. Until you have it all, you won't be free. Society, you're a crazy breed. I hope you're not lonely without me.
One more than you have. I see
think you need.
One,
and
two,
when you think more than
three,
you want,
four,
your thoughts begin to bleed.
There's fishing boats out there. I'm surprised there's not more today.
Think I need to find a bigger place.
If you go down around under the Falls,
there's
some flats out there. It's a good spot to
catch
walleye.
Need more space.
I've caught a few walleye out here. This is
an
man, I tell you what, it gets
your
busy
crazy
on the weekend.
Breeze.
Come out here once on the 4th of July, the whole bank,
without
as far as you go up this lake,
society.
You can find a place to put a boat in. The
crazy
wedge
and
be.
I hope you're not lonely, without me.
It's a nice lake, you know, with being 20 minutes, a half hour from home. It's pretty eerie. The foliage is, I don't know if you call it peak or just a past peak, but just a beautiful area. Beautiful area.
Thinking more, less is more. But if less is more, how you keeping score? It means for every point you make, your level drops. Kinda like you're starting from the top. And you can't do that, society. You're a crazy breed. I hope you're not lonely without me. Society, crazy Andy. I hope you're not lonely without me. Society, have mercy on me. I hope you're not angry if I disagree. Society, crazy Andy. Hope you're not lonely without me.
We are headed toward the canal town of Matamora, Indiana. There's still an old canal left there. Some of it. They still run a period canal boat on. I'm going to take you by there and show you what that looks like. there's an old rail line off to the left of me here. That's part of the Indiana Historical Railroad. They do Christmas rides, train rides. That comes out of Connersville, Indiana. If you're in the area, check it out. It's a good time. An old canal town. They still using a Peary canal boat. Huh, usually the canal boat sits right here. This is the canal, right there's the dock for the canal boat. They're not using it today. It's gone. There's a historical cross in town here too. I can't remember exactly where it's at. I think it's right here. The old grist mill, water powered grist mill. Whitewater Canal. Historical site. This is the little area where they have shops and stuff here to get little things. Fall of the year, it's real popular. Shaft for the mill runs under the road. This is part of the railroad tracks. I was telling you that the Indiana Historical Railroad runs on, but we got water coming in today. This is still the remnants of the old canal locks that used to run through here. The old locks. want to show you this white oak, how this limb is. There's a story behind this limb, but nobody would probably know. Something in this tree's past, something pushed this limb down, and it has got on the ground and continued to grow. As you can see, it's perfectly alive and doing well. It's massive. Something to see, ain't it? There's a story. An animal, somebody has bent this down and it has continued to thrive. Nature has its way. Just leave it be, and it either continues and goes on or goes away. Here's a plaque for the passenger pigeon. Passenger pigeon extinction. Big store extinction. Vast numbers of passenger pigeons migrated through Indiana, with many nesting in the state's forests in the spring. Pigeon roosts, which spread over miles, could damage and topple trees, often attracted and amazed onlookers and hunters. The last verified passenger pigeon in the wild was shot about 5 miles from here near Laurel on April 3rd, 1902. No more passenger pigeons. That's interesting. Starting to warm up a little bit. Starting to warm up. I want to see if this big sycamore stump is still over here. They used to have a sycamore, a cut out of a sycamore tree that was unbelievable huge. It's gone. It's no longer here. It used to sit right out here. It's gone. All right, let's continue on. We're going to head to Oldenburg. I'm at this vintage bike shop here in Matamore, Indiana. Have I got some stuff to show you.
Yeah, it might make him be able to sell it up to him.
So these are gasket kits for 48 to 54. This is new old stock military, correct? Harley military?
Yeah. Yeah, because here it says military use only.
Yeah, here's piston pins. What year are these for?
Those should be for the 48.
48. Old stock Harley Davidson. If you need parts, you got to get over here to this guy. He's got them. He's got the vintage stuff.
Yeah, and then the bearings up there.
Same year?
Yeah.
Man, where did you find these at? Just swap meets or?
No, well, I traded for them from a guy that had them. Had a bunch of them.
Wow.
Yeah, those are new coils.
New coils?
Yeah.
What are just gasket kits
gasket
too?
Kits, yeah, for that'd be for 55.
55 through 65, complete set of motor gaskets replacement, and that is old new stock.
Yep, and then this crate's full. I think it's full of gaskets. Yeah, it'll be full of gasket sets.
That's the original crate, ain't it?
Yeah, military crate.
Military motorcycle crate with all new old parts in it.
It's old military crate. Oh, I'm not sure what it got in that.
Yeah,
look at it. Yeah. Piston pins. Oh, them's gasket sets there.
Piston pins, gasket sets.
Yeah.
Man, if you need vintage Harley parts, you got to get over here to this shop in Matamoros, Indiana. He's got it, you know.
Yeah, new gas caps for the old bikes.
Gas caps?
Yeah, gas caps for the old bikes. They're still. Military army
gas caps.
Yeah, I've never had that. So.
New old stock.
Yeah.
Wow. You know, there's people out there searching the internet to find them, and you got a box full of them.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep. There was 160 pieces.
160 pieces.
Yeah.
Them fit what year?
Them should be the old school, because I put them on some of the older gas tanks, some of the real old gas tanks.
Yeah, they'll fit
they
the older stuff.
They don't fit the new stuff.
Tell you what.
Seats. Old seats there. A lot of people hunt for them when they're redoing old bikes.
Oh, yeah. What's your main ride?
Right now, this one. I got rid of my other bike, and that one there is going to be... That trike out there, a blue trike.
That trike?
Yeah, that's my right name too. And I'm keeping both of them. I sold a 66 old Ironhead a couple weeks ago. It was a one owner. 23,000 original miles and a four-digit serial number.
Four-digit?
Yeah.
Wow.
I appraised it at 16.5 to 18.5.
This information, I will get this out there.
Yeah, it's all for sale except for the black chopper.
I'll get this today. This will go out to the people that's into this stuff.
You don't mind those pump, do you?
Oh, no, it's your shop.
Yeah.
Did you build this?
No, I traded one of them new Can-Ams in on it. I rode that Can-Am for a week or so, and I didn't really care for it. And I seen this, and I ended up trading it.
Ride pretty decent?
Yeah, it does pretty good. Yep.
There you go. You got a phone number to get a hold of you? Let me get your phone number right here. That's my phone.
Oh, that's what I say. Yeah. Oh, you got a camera deal there.
Yeah. There's a number to get them vintage parts.
Yeah, name of the shop for the old school.
Okay, yeah. Here's the name of the shop from the old school. This is the place for the parts that you need. There's Panhead and Shovelhead jugs. Man, those are in excellent shape. A little machine work, that'd be good to go.
Yeah. And I got old brake shoes. And
cranks, brake shoes.
Yeah.
Clutches.
Oh, transmission gears.
Transmission gears. This is the place to come.
Be nice find somebody to buy it out.
Carburetor. This is made for racing.
Yeah.
If I Google what?
Google Lens it. You know how you just take a picture of something and it tells you what it is? How
right,
much.
Right.
It's quite scary, the price.
What do they say it goes for? What do they say it goes for?
It says on the internet $2,400.
$2,400?
Yep. Yeah, a friend of mine, well, the guy stopped in, he says, I have one just like that. He said he ended up selling for $500. He said he could have got, you know, $1,000 out of it easy, but it said it's one.
New old stock lenses for a 48, possibly 48.
Let's see what that says.
Here, I want to make sure I hand that back to you. Make sure you got a hold of it.
Yeah.
Let me get a part number on this one. Get that number and a part number. Got it.
Yep. Yep, they're hard for you.
That's a strike die. That's a strike die from something. They actually struck something. That's a press die.
Yeah, for pressing hardy plates. I think it makes them. Looks like it makes those. Except for maybe a little bit littler than that.
I think you got it. Where'd you find that at?
It came with the parts that I bought.
Parts with the ball?
A lot of the parts. In a box, in the bottom of a box.
Amazing, all these new old stock parts and the back roads of Indiana. Look at this. Ignition coils. Military piston rings.
I didn't see
this is a Harley Davidson trench lighter. Now, how does that work again? Pull it. Let me see how that works.
Just pull that down.
Pull that down. Okay. Yeah. I see.
Put it back up.
Now, what about this other one?
That one there.
That's also a lighter.
You take his cap off and strike it, and then put the cap back on, and then you take it off and take that all the way out, and you can take the wick out and fill it full of fluid, and then this here you unscrew it, and the flint's inside here.
Manufactured by Harley.
No, well, that one, no, that one I don't think is.
Oh, that was not?
No, but it's called a trench lighter, too.
Trench lighter.
Yeah.
Colt.
That one said
$277.
$277? No, I was going to ask $200 for the pair.
$200 for the pair?
Yeah.
Well, we're on Indiana State Route 229, headed into Matamora, headed into Oldenburg. And this is a beautiful, beautiful curvy road. It's really pretty to ride through here. Wow, what a treat seeing all those old vintage, old new stock Harley parts in stock in a little town in Indiana. There's somebody out there on the computer looking for those parts.
desert wind. Here she comes and then she's gone again. And I'm just a traveler on this earth. Shut my heart behind the pocket of my shirt. I just keep rolling till I'm in. Yeah, 'cause I'm a traveler. Like the rubber turning on the ground, always lost and nowhere bound. I'm just a traveler on this earth. Shut my heart behind the pocket of my shirt. I just keep rolling till I'm in dirt, 'cause I'm a traveler.
I'm here in Oldenburg, Indiana. There's the Sisters of St. Francis convent. Convent and chapel. I think this is where they educate nuns coming in, I think. Sisters of the Franciscan. A beautiful building. The architecture is just gorgeous. Wow, how was they able in the 1800s to scaffold, build in brick, and hoist that Indiana sandstone up on a unit like that? Unbelievable. Right up here to my right is the Village Inn that's got some of the best fried chicken you can get anywhere. They still fry it in a cast iron skillet. Man, it is. People come from all over, even out of state, to get chicken at Wagner's Village Inn. You got to have the fried chicken, and they make their own hot sauce, and it is awesome. Now we're 229, we're headed into Batesville, Indiana. When I was younger, I used to come here and work. I was a service tech. I come here and worked at the Batesville Casket Company. I was here a few times, really didn't like it, didn't care for it, but somebody's got to do it. I was servicing some equipment they had here. Batesville Casket Company. All right, let's continue on.